Hello everyone, this is the Blue Dragon Gamer, and after watching the opening sequence, we're ready to play Scooby-Doo Mystery Mayhem. Let's begin with Episode 1, The Haunting of Hambridge.
Almost there.
Where? In the mall shop?
Don't you guys ever think of anything else?
Sure, like sometimes we think of breakfast. Or lunch.
Yeah, lunch.
So what's the story this time?
My old neighborhood librarian, Mr. Dinsdale, has just been put in charge of the Hambridge University Library. But it seems the library is full of ghosts.
Ghosts?
A haunted library? Interesting.
Dinkley, you're late. And speaking of late, you still owe a $2 late charge on the junior detective handbook.
But that was in the fourth grade.
We'll solve this matter later, Miss Dinkley. Now, it seems that you and your friends have made quite a name for yourselves dealing with ghouls and ghosts.
We always get our monster.
Or man in a monster suit, as it usually turns out.
Is that so?
Jeepers, or maybe not.
Okay, gang, you know the drill. Let's split up and get to the bottom of this mystery. Shaggy, you and Scooby check out the basement.
Hey, like why do we always get the basement?
Basement? Uh-uh.
Like no way. There's always freaky stuff in basements.
Yeah.
I'm so sorry, but we've lost the key to the basement.
See, we can't go. There's no key.
Allow me to introduce Walter Peabody, my assistant. He's in charge of restoring old books.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Peabody.
The pleasure is all mine.
A missing key? Let's keep an eye out for it, guys.
Yeah, well, you can look out for keys. We're looking out for ghosts.
Well.
Like you go look around, Scoob. I'll wait here.
What? You're a coward.
A coward? Me? Why, I resent that. I have sensitive nerves. Would a coward boldly go through that door over there?
Here we are given a task to find the old library.
Thank you.
the door on the left is locked, so that just leaves the door in the center.
Look, Scoob, a camera! Wanna take a picture to keep as a souvenir?
Yeah!
Like Groovy! Now if things get too scary, we can always remember happier times!
Use the camera to save your game.
Frankie, look, costumes!
Hey, maybe we can put these on to confuse the ghosts.
Use the ghost costume to sneak past the ghost. The door in the center is locked and we need a key to open it. Here we are given a task to get the annex key. As we head up the stairs, we find our first clue.
Hey, a clue!
Like you're right, Scoob. This looks like a clue. We should find Velma and show it to her.
Bring Velma the clue, who's around the corner, to get more information about it.
Great! You've found a clue! Remember, at any time you can look at all your clues in this episode file. Get enough clues and you'll unlock special bonuses too! So, have you two found a way to the basement yet?
Nope, not yet.
That seems to be a young Alan Dinsdale in Washington, D.C. You can see the Capitol in the background.
As you can see, we got more information about the clue we found. Head over to the door on the right.
Wow! This room is a mess! Well, maybe we can find some food on top of these crates.
Climb up the nearby crates. Here we find our second clue.
I found something!
Good job, Scoob! Scooby-Doo, are you all right?
No, I'm hungry!
As we make our way around, push the button to move the ladder. Climb up the ladder where we'll find the annex key. This completes getting the key to the annex. Now we can leave the room. Let's bring the second clue to Velma.
Great! You found a clue! This was probably addressed to Walter Peabody. It says, package received. Check is in the mail. S.D.
Now that we have the key, we can head through the door in the center. But before I do, I'm gonna put on a ghost costume to help sneak past the ghost.
Maggie, you're a ghost!
Yeah, like Boo, man! Like that book card's blocking the way! Hey, Scoob, maybe you can squeeze under those tables and push the cart from the other side.
Wait for the costume to wear off.
Now try to crawl under that table, Scoob! Careful, Scoob!
Use Scooby-Doo to crawl under the table.
Good job, Scooby, old pal! Now try to push those carts out of the way.
Here we are given a task to get Shaggy to follow Scooby. Start by pushing the first cart out of the way. Here we see our third clue on a bookcase. Let's climb up and get it.
What's this?
Head it over and push the second cart out of the way. This completes getting Shaggy to follow Scooby.
Scooby-Doo!
Raggy!
Now that we have Shaggy, we can climb up these crates in the corner. Here we see our first sandwich ingredient. Let's get it.
See, Scoob? I told you there was some food around here somewhere. Come on, let's find all those ingredients and make a super-duper triple-decker sandwich.
Scooby-dooby-doo!
So our first ingredient is ham. Head to the next room.
What's wrong, Scooby? Oh no! Ghosts!
What do we do, Raggy?
Try to make as little noise as possible.
Here we see our second sandwich ingredient above the bookcase. Oops, accidentally went through the door. Climb up to get it. That was close, that ghost almost got us. So our second ingredient is a tomato. Put on the ghost costume and make your way past the ghosts. The door on the right is locked. Use the camera to save your game. Head through the door on the left.
We made it, Scoob! We got past the ghosts! We're safe! We're safe?
Boom.
Here there's a shadow walking around. Be careful and stay to the outer edges to get past it.
Phew! We almost got spotted by another one of those ghosts! Is it just me, or did it walk kind of funny?
A ghost? A rock?
Well, I think we found a way into the basement.
No.
Like this must be the old library that old Mr. Peabody was talking about.
This completes finding the old library, and we're given a task to find the fake ghost hideout. That ghost came out of nowhere. Use the camera to save your game. I'll grab a Scooby snack to recover. That was close. Good thing Shaggy jumped out of the way. Put on the ghost costume and make your way past the ghosts. Be sure to get the fourth clue in the corner.
Is it a cookbook? Oh, it's a clue.
Head through the door.
Like this place really creeps me out.
Be careful of the shadow walking around. Use the camera to save your game. Head through the door on the right. Be careful of some more shadows walking around. This door is locked and we need a key to open it. Head through the door on the right. Be careful of some more shadows walking around. Open the door in the center to find a box of Scooby snacks. Open the door on the right to find the hideout key. Now that we have the key, we can go through the locked room. I have to say, after seeing the pictures on the wall, I think this place was haunted before the ghosts showed up. I mean, look, they have blue faces. Use the camera to save your game. Climb up on the bookcase to scout out the area. Put on the ghost costume and make your way past the ghosts. Don't mind us, just two ghosts walking by. Head through the door.
Like, look at that freaky book, Scoob! Raggy! What did you find there, Scoob?
Hey!
Like, maybe it's a clue!
Zoinks!
That book just gobbled up the ghost like it was an eggplant and marshmallow sandwich.
Sandwich? Where?
Like, hey, Scoob, let's show this ghost gobbling book to the others.
It's a clue, a clue.
As you can see, we found our fifth clue and completed finding the fake ghost hideout and given a task to get back to the library lobby. Use the camera to save your game. This is a wisp generator, which I will be talking more about later. Head back through the door.
Velma! Like, what are you doing here?
Shaggy? Scooby? Is that you? I can't see anything without my glasses. I was following a rather strange-looking ghost when I tripped over a book and lost them. Can you help me find them, please?
Here we are given a task to find Velma's glasses. And it looks as though Velma's doing the mannequin challenge. Carefully make your way past the ghosts. That was close. Good thing Shaggy jumped. Here we find Velma's glasses on the bookcase.
Shaggy, you're
put on the ghost costume and make your way back to Velma.
Boo, man.
Now we'll just join Velma in the mannequin challenge until our costumes wear off.
Here you go, Velma.
Thanks, Shaggy. Hey, what's this?
It's a groovy old book me and Scoob found. And like when I say ghosts are into this book, I mean ghosts are into this book.
From the looks of it, I'd say it's a medieval grimoire. It's missing a few pages. Interesting. There seems to be some instructions on how to capture spirits. It says here that you need to have the right page to capture the right kind of creature. Right now, there's only one page. The ghost page. All the pages for other monsters are missing. The more pages we can find, the more kinds of enemies we can gobble up. But it says here you need to charge up the book with magical wisps first.
Like, how do we do that?
Just walk up to them. Or, if you can't reach them, open the Tome of Doom, and they'll be drawn to it, as long as you face them.
Okay, so like, how do we capture the ghosts?
It says here that if a ghost passes in front of the open Tome of Doom, it will automatically get hooked. Once you've got it, you have to reel the enemy into the book by bringing its energy down.
Woody!
Hey! Hey, guys. Try catching the ghosts over there. Be careful, though. If you get attacked, the ghost might break free.
This completes finding Velma's glasses, and we're given a task to capture all the ghosts in the basement. This is the end of part 1 of episode 1, The Haunting of Hambridge.